presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy camo! I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't make assumptions. Learn to ask questions. It's always better to ask questions than to make assumptions. Have the courage to ask questions unto you as clear as you can be. Once you hear the answer to the question, you won't have to make the assumption because you will know the truth. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 199. NASDAQ is up 78. S&P's down 10. Gold contract up $16.80, trading at $17.38 an ounce. Silver up 42 cents, $18.21 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 20 cents, $39.14 a barrel. Notes and bonds. We have the 10-year right now trading up 25 ticks, 138.16. The 30-year down a point and 22 ticks at 175.31. And King Dollar. King Dollar's down 254 ticks, trading 96.07. The euro is at 113. The yen is at 107.32. And the British pound is at 127 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You got a sideways market out here. We have the SPYs trading down 46 cents. You had a low out here today in the SPY of 318. High of 322, bottom line just going sideways out here. NDX 100, different ball game, all-time highs. We take a look at the NDX, the 3Qs. 3Qs right now trading up $3.61, 246.93. And just to give you an idea, folks, when it blew away this high, its last all-time high before the COVID-19 came in, that high was 237.47. And, of course, inside of the NDX 100, what you're going to see, the move is out here, pretty extraordinary. Tesla is up 7.8%. Tesla hit a high out here today of 1,019. You're trading 1,014 right now. Zoom up 6.9%. That's trading at 219. You get IDEX Pharmaceutical, which is up 6.3%. That's trading $322. And you get Seattle Genetics, which is up 5.3%. Taken away from the NDX 100 is United down 9.5%. Align Technologies off 4%. Starbucks off 3.5%. And Marriott is down 3.2%. Gold contract out here caught a bid. Bottom line, should catch a bid when you listen to what the Federal Reserve is going to do and saying out here. Up $18, you got 174,000 contracts. So the bottom line is that you've done two different things here. You've broken the downtrend and the gold market that has been in place since the 18th of May. You know, we've had a consolidation. This has been consolidating going all the way back to June, to April 9th. So we broke topside. You had volume on the break topside. It's an ABC structure on the way up. You got an 1821 to 1825 price projection. That being said, but then when we talk about how we've drifted lower, we drifted lower right from the 18th of May, laying out a low out here last Friday afternoon at 1671. Right now you're at 1739. You've broken the downtrend. That's number one. That's saying you're going right up back up to these 1789. levels, and then we'll see. Bottom line is if we can get that ABC price projection. Silver contract right now also caught a bid. Silver's up 43 cents. You got almost 80,000 contracts traded already. Silver also wants to make a run, $19, $20. Right now you're trading at $18.23. Notes and bonds, bottom line, the Fed's coming out. They're going to be buying them once again. Not once again, they've been buying them, period. Bottom line is that the 30-year still has a... Not that, well, let's see. We're at 175.30, 176. It's about another point in order to get into the range once again. You know, we dropped out of that range. It broke the 2.5-month consolidation. And guess what? Just jumped right back inside the range. The 10-year is already back inside the higher range. King dollar, folks, down 322 ticks, trading 96.01. We bring this back. What you're going to see inside King dollar is that if we break this 94 area, King Dollar will make that run down to 88. The last time we were down to 88 was February, I believe. Yeah, it was February of 2018. So we'll see. You know, there's not a lot of support at the 94.650, but the bottom line, I expect you're going to get there, number one. But if we slice through that area, then you are going to see some heavy destruction inside the U.S. dollar. If we do go over and we take a look at the euro, you're going to see the euro caught a bid. That's up 45 ticks right now. That's going after its swing high of 114. You're at 113.86. You go take a look at the British pound. Same type of setup in the pounds, meaning pound is up, is trading 127.54. And that baby looks like it wants to run up to this 132. And then if we go over to the yen is getting strong in a big way. JPY, let's pull that. The yen right now, this is down an additional 51 ticks right now. We are at 107.24. Now the yen's making a run down to this 105. You break 105 in the yen, and then you're talking some real action, meaning 101. That would be one monster move, folks. No two ways about that. Let's look at some of the higher volume equities in this market. We'll see whether we get any volume as we come into the end of the day. Hertz is the big number. That's down $1.40, trading at 276. You get American down 145. Ford's down 38 cents. Norwegian is off $3, or 15%. United's down $4, or 10%. You get Boeing down $10, that's only 5%. Delta's off $2.53, trading 31. Same old culprits at the top of the higher volume once again, folks, meaning that the equities that really are dead cat bounces. Now, they've been very large dead cat bounces, no doubt about that. Percentage-wise, big number, no two ways about that. That being said, guess what? Still problematic. Amazon, out here today, you're up $52 right now. It had a high today of $27.22. Right now, you're $26.53. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials down 140. NASDAQ is up 99. S&Ps are off 3. We'll come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Right now down 167. We'll get the NASDAQ up 95. S&Ps are up 3.5. Let's go take a look at Newmont for one of the tigers out here. So Newmont, one of the largest gold companies in the world. The low's 33, the high's 69 the past 12 months. You're trading out here at 58.54. Okay, so when we take a look at this, the question is, it's not an ABC structure on the way up and on the way down right now. Bottom line is that you're starting a new leg. We would have started a new leg on Friday when that low came in at a 52.33. That being said, you get some good volume out here in these equities, number one. And so, let's see if I put this on a weekly. Yeah, it's got decent volume up to like 61. So it's going to need more volume when it makes a run to the next high, because you can see the contraction. This had an amazing run, as the market did. And in March, the stock was at $33, ran all the way up to 69, just had a retracement back to 52. You had a retracement back to the breakout area. That's saying number one will go to 61, and then we'll see whether it can get up to those highs once again of the 69 area. Franco-Nevada, we'll take a look at some of these, a bunch of these golds, actually. Franco-Nevada, this is a nice liftoff. Bottom line is that this is an equity to really watch, too, because what you have with Franco-Nevada, this keeps hitting all-time highs. And what Franco-Nevada did do, that, went from a price point of $77 all the way up to $153. Came back to the breakout area. These are classics, too. And Franco-Nevada right now is up $5.18. And you can see it's a decisive break of the downtrend that's been in place here since May 18th. We go take a look at Royal Gold. Now, Royal was weaker than Franco-Nevada. But like, there you go. It's picking it up today, too. Up another $5 today. 127, same deal. This very well could be the beginning of a nice little run here. The Fed is out of the way. The Fed's saying zero rates for two more years. Bottom line, the dollar is going south. Gold as well as silver is going north. And the interest rate structure is going to stay flat. In fact, let's go just take a look at this. You have the 10-year right now at 0.74. We started off last week at 0.65, we went to 0.90. We're back down into the lower level here. The GDX, same setup. Yeah, these are running. So the GDX, back to the breakout area, broke the downtrend today. They all broke the downtrend today. So what's really cool, folks, when the Fed comes out is that, and now this, well, I'm saying it's really cool. It's really cool today versus really cool all the time, because what does happen is this. When the Fed comes out and the news that gets created there and the dollar pulls back and gold goes higher, bottom line, then gold can get some breathing room. That's how this thing shakes out, because the heavier news about what the Fed's doing is out. When it's not cool, of course, is that if it's just the opposite and they say they're going to put the screws on it, then you can get gold going south in an incredible way. This is, I would say, this is the first time that I've seen, I think, well, we've all seen, that it's unheard of that you have a Federal Reserve that is saying the bottom line is that you can expect these rates to go on till 2022. I mean, that's about as wild as you get. And I love the quote about not even thinking about raising rates. That is quite a quote, folks, okay? They do think that, you know, this year the GDP is going to pull back about 6.5%. Next year, they think that it's going to go back up 5%. Well, that still leaves us with a minus 1.5 from where we started from. You know, we'll see where that shakes out. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the X on these big oil integrators. So ExxonMobil, this hit a low out here, $30 in March. You're at 51 right now. Had a nice, you know, pop. It got over the consolidation last week. Had some juice over the consolidation also. Now, you're getting a hard pullback out here today. So we'll see. There's not an expansion of volume, which is positive. That being said, when you get a hard pullback like this and you can't hold price, that will be, we'll get another day inside of these energies that want to go south. That's how this baby shakes out. So the number to keep your eye on here is going to be 47.68 inside ExxonMobil, and that's trading 51 right now. If we take a look at Chevron right now is trading down 2.5%. Yeah, still stronger than Exxon. Interesting, man. Yeah, still stronger than Exxon. You know, so Chevron would have to get back inside the 95.56 area in order to basically say that was a false break topside as that baby had taken off. We take a look at the Facebook. Facebook today was up. I think it's down a couple bucks right now. It's down 76 cents. That the high in Facebook, let me see, is this an all-time high? Yeah, all-time high today, 241.21. So you get Facebook running. This is what the Nasdaq's all about. You get Apple. The price-wise in Apple is pretty amazing, folks, okay? So Apple's up another $9.46. Well, in 4 days, Apple's gone from 323 to 353. And that is quite an extraordinary feat when you have 4.3 billion, with a B, shares outstanding. Google was up a little bit early. I believe it's flat right now. No, it's still up. It's up 13 bucks. Google doesn't have the juice behind it as an Apple does. That being said, though, guess what? You know, it's reaching for its high. The high that it's reaching for is at 1532. Microsoft, which got into its highs yesterday, just blowing the highs away. I mean, this is just Microsoft today. When you talk about getting up to a high and then just taking off like a rocket ship, well, good old Microsoft did it again. Bottom line, the high was $190.70. Right now, you're at $197.79. Now, the further you push away from a high or a low, folks, the higher that you could actually go. So this is quite a number. Huge number. Absolutely huge number. And you got the short position is not what's driving that. Their short position is only 0.5%. Let's go take a look at STT for State Street Corporation for one of the targets out here. Lows 42, the highs 85. This is a huge back office. You're down 350. All the financials out here, folks, basically are down today, and they're down pretty good. So if you own this baby, you know, you don't want to get back inside 62.51. That's for sure. That's what it looks to me like it's going to head, because it broke topside, as did all the banks. All the banks out here, let's just take a look at J.P. Morgan quick. Before the break, J.P. Morgan, same deal. J.P. Morgan's off $4. You know, from last week, you went from 115 to 106. Now, that's very unusual inside the banking structures, folks, that you're going up or down 5 or 10 points every couple days. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is sure a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market, Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour, Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m., Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m., and Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow's down 74. NASDAQ is up 126. S&Ps are up 5.5. Let's go take a look at those NQs for a second, just in the future market. See if they want to run this baby right into the close. This is going to be what a close this is going to be. So we get 30 minutes into the close, folks. They get the run going on right now, just as we're speaking. You just had the futures overtake the high that was generated out here this morning at, 2:30 this afternoon. And it has volume behind the move. So that's saying that baby does want to continue getting it to higher price. Let's go take a look at, NK, SLA. This is one of the rocket ships that have no revenue, but yet we're trading at $67, and they got a market cap of $24 billion right now. That being said, let's see what we have out here. So intraday, you basically get a flat market out here. What you have done, this is, if you're trading this thing, bottom line is that, it came back to the highs of the low of yesterday, which is 66.50. We're at the 65.27. And you can see this is pretty weird, man. I mean, the bottom line is that there is not sellers in the stock. You know, on an intraday basis, you can see this pretty well here, the way this is set up. You know, it's very unusual, folks, when you see something intraday that has been a rocket ship, and then as you pull back, it just settles down. So let's see on a basis, and the question is going to be here is that, could this be an ABC structure on the way up on a daily? And yeah, it can. We'll see. If it is, it's going to be a monster. If it is, you get 40 as your A, 93 as your B. So what's that, $53, right? It's a big number. What you're gonna have to get here, well, you can see the contraction of volumes pretty dramatically. Yesterday, what we did, you did 70 million shares on the way up, 23 on the way back. It's still coming into 50. So, yeah, it could be. And if that's the case, what that's going to be all about, it's going to be about that short position, I suspect, is going to keep climbing. Right now, you get a short position of 1.63%. I can't quite figure that baby out in a monster way of how it can be running that dramatically. And, yes, anyone that's trading that on an ABC structure up, particularly if you're trading it. Yeah, so we got a couple of tigers that are trading it in a in the option market, I believe. Let me see. NKLA, just to make sure that they actually have options. Is it? Yeah, there's options on it too. Unreal. So, yeah, they got an option on it. As the tiger saying that if in fact that happens, he's going to be driving one of those big rigs. Well, I don't know, those big rigs, we'll see whether they get a car made in 5 years, 10 years, whatever they do, but it won't matter. You can spend it on something, that's for sure. Let's go take a look at the platinum market. I haven't looked at platinum for a long time. Okay, and I should be looking at that because I own platinum. So platinum is 849. This is still amazing. Still no traction, man. You know, bottom line, we've been going sideways since May 18th. You pull this up, and PL1. Let me put this. Let me get a generic chart. Because this is something that just went supply versus demand, folks. That there's just no demand in the platinum market. It's pretty amazing looking at this chart. Yeah, we still haven't broken the downtrend. We've been in a downtrend in platinum since $1,918 since August of 2011. That's a long time. It's come all the way back to levels that were trading in 2004. That's just plenty. Let me go look at the palladium. I want to look at palladium because that's just the different. Yeah, look at this. This is sick. This is where the palladium right now. Whoa, what? Yeah, palladium's trading at $1,951. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. $1,951. It hit a high of $2,883. Monster numbers, man. Monster numbers. Will, you know, see with zero rates for a longer period of time if, in fact, anything can get juice, meaning if the platinum market can get juice. Copper, let's go take a look at the copper market out here. Copper's caught a huge bid out here, folks. And this is going to be active copper contract. You're up 9.5 cents out here today. You get 90,000 contracts traded. You're trading at 269. This is a break top side. So this is good for the metals market in general, meaning even the gold market. So copper wants to run to 286. We're at 269. We take a look at Southern Copper. This is the largest copper company in the world. Only up 67 cents. No big deal there. FCX, Freeport-McMoRan. This is up 15 cents, so it's intriguing. So for the amount of that the copper market is actually up today, you don't have these babies running as much as they could be. Let me look at Taseko. Let's see. I haven't seen this one. I forget what that symbol is. Taseko is a... That's also a copper company that does like to run, and it's a very high personality stock. There's no two ways about that. Gold still running somewhat up there. We go take a look at Ford as well as GM. Ford right now trading down 37 cents. That's at $6.80. That had a low of $3.96. We go take a look at GM. GM's not a bad setup. Okay, so GM came back from $14. You're 29 right now. It's filling a gap. Yeah, looks like GM bottom line does look like it wants to get up to a little bit higher price. Boeing came out that what they're saying here now. Boeing is closing on a key milestone towards returning the 737 MAX to the commercial market. They're targeting later this month. They're going to be hosting U.S. regulators on a flight to test the jet's upgraded systems. The company separately is notifying the airlines of an important fix, and the grounded jet line is wiring, said two people familiar with the planning and asked not to be named. A draft of revised pilot training for the plane, which has been parked around the world since March of 2019 as a result of two fatal crashes which killed 346 people. The moves were strong indicators that Boeing is fully nearing the end of the jet's 15-month grounding and controversy that has engulfed the company after two fatal crashes. The aviation titan has estimated that it's going to spend $20 billion compensating customers, keeping supplies afloat, and restoring the production of the jets. So they still get a long way ahead. First, you got to convince people to get on a plane. Then you got to convince them to get on a 737 MAX. Dow Industrials up 128. NASDAQ is Dow down 128. NASDAQ up 120. S&P's flat. We'll come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down 140. NASDAQ is up 122. S&Ps are flat. Let's go over, and I got to see this, folks, okay? So we've been talking about Robinhood a lot, and we're going to be talking about Robinhood a lot because there's no doubt that these traders can run stocks. So thanks, CKS, for bringing this up. So check this out. Let's see what this is. Okay, so this equity here, okay, operates online financial marketplace. The company focuses on facilitated mid to long-term customer loans. Bottom line, it's a Chinese company. Let's see what kind of revenue they have. Okay, looks like they're saying that they do $1.7 billion. And, oh my God. This is like even, this is about as sick as you get. Okay, this this is crazy, folks. Listen to this. This equity yesterday was at $2.33. It runs to $30 today. Now you're at $5. Is this correct? Come on. Yeah, it's correct. Bottom line is that it opened today at $10.54, runs all the way up to $30, and now you are all the way back to $5.56. We're going to see this phenomenon more and more. And if you do want to watch how they're trending on Robinhood, it's RobinTrack. I believe that's the, it's RobinTrack. And what RobinTrack does, folks, is that they'll tell you every hour what is trending in Robinhood. And, bottom line is you get some heavy momentum, even if these folks are buying, whether it's 100 shares, 1,000 shares, 50 shares, you get 10 million. Well, they have 10 million accounts. So the bottom line is that, even if 2 million accounts are trading simultaneously, and, bottom line, you can run stocks like that. There's no two ways about it. The thing that's so intriguing about this is that when you think about the social platforms in general, I'm wondering, how are they going to get a handle on this? Because all you have to do is you find a stock that is low priced, you get people start buying it, the buying accelerates itself. As the buy-in accelerates itself, what ends up happening is that, yes, that the equity is going to go higher. And there's no doubt this is turning into like a pinball game, folks, okay? That's, Is it real? It's real because we're talking real money. Have we seen it before? Yeah, I've seen it before. You have to actually go back to the 90s for something like this that would run. I remember when CNBC... I forget the guy they had on. He ended up in trouble because he was running the stocks, and then the reason he got in trouble, though, he's telling other people before he come on that he was going to run, not that he's going to run the stock, but at that particular point, what would end up happening, this is when all the Souls bands are around, Dan Dorfman, thanks Morgan, appreciate it, yes, Dan Dorfman. So what happened there is that we would be in front of our computers just waiting to hear whatever stock he said, it didn't matter, we hit the button. And we'd only be in those trades for like 30 seconds. It was that dramatic. In fact, one of the Tigers had given me another one of these. This is like crazy, man. You're going to have to. So this is Wins Finance Holdings. This is also another Chinese company. Oh, my God. Okay, so this is at an all-time high, too. This company, this is a joke. This company takes in $13 million a year. Oh, man. This doesn't even make any sense. Okay, so this stock here, folks, started out yesterday at $7.50, ran up to $64.35 today. It's trading, well, right now it's just halted. The last time it was halted, $19.35. And this is just a trading halt for volatility. So this equity will open back up. That's about as wild as you get. We're near highs, folks. That's the real bottom line. You know, this is the stuff that happens at when you're not only near highs, that is telling me that we're going to have a heck of a correction once again. Because they just come in. That's when it's the Wild West out here, that's when you get some real damage inside of the marketplace. Let's go take a look at the XAU, the HUI. XAU out here today, also broke its downtrend, up $4.70. Gold Bugs Index, going to be the same deal in here. We get some buy-in in here. Gold Bugs Index up by 10.25. Both of these are the gold market in general, folks, has been a classic, meaning that we accelerated on the way up. You had a breakout area of the 22nd of April. That was in the contracts as well as the equities. Then you had the volume there. You pull back into the lower price point where the breakout is. You had lighter volume. Now right away, we get acceleration on the way up again. You're getting wide price spread. You're getting heavier volume. You got it all. We go over to that dollar. What you're going to see is that the dollar, this is really fast moves inside the dollar, folks. We're down 384 out here today. This is going after this. We're at 95 already, but that's saying it's going to go after the 94. And the yen just keeps getting stronger. As the yen keeps getting stronger, folks, that makes the gold contract much stronger. The yen right now is trading at 107.16. The number you want to keep your eye on here is 107.09. We hit 107.76. 106.99 today. You know, I suspect it's going to break that. It looks to me like this thing's going to run down to the 105.99. That is on a shorter term basis. But that will keep the juice going inside of the gold market. And then we have here, of course, we're already in Wednesday. And as I said a little bit earlier, with gold holding, and in fact, it's getting stronger coming into the close right now, that most times what you're going to see, you're going to get another acceleration tomorrow. Because if we have, like, gold right now is up $26. Gold was flat when the Fed came out with the numbers. It was up $10 earlier, and it sold off. So we start out the day, it's up $10 or $12. They sell it down to flat. Fed comes out, takes off like a rocket ship, as did silver. Silver right now is up 56 cents. That's trading $18.35. And dollar, as I said a little bit earlier, that is getting some heavy pressure. And these other currencies want higher price. So I suspect there's going to be a lot more selling pressure inside of the dollar. Let's go take a look at Aneco Eagle, AEM. Same deal. Broke consolidation. Broke the downtrend. They all did it. You know, Aneco Eagle was down to $55 last week. You're trading 61 right now. The differential, an Eco Eagle doesn't have a high volume high. So there's a few of these gold equities that the run was so extraordinary. They don't have high volume highs. What they're going to need as they start going up there, we're going to need an expansion of volume as we're getting that expansion of price. Dow Industrials right now, down 180, NASDAQ up 91, S&P's down 6. Come right back.
In the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by,
bam!
As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down at 200. NASDAQ's up 82. NASDAQ, S&Ps are off 10. And thanks, Dan, for sending this over. So I was talking about copper. Taseko was the number what I was looking for, TGB. So this equity is trading at 52 cents. The low for this year is 20 cents. The high, 61. This is a big copper equity. And this has some juice behind it, man. On the weekly, so check this out. This equity looks like, number one, it got back inside the range. It's going to go after, you're at 52, it's going to go after 61. What it has sticking out like a sore thumb is 79. So this has some juice in it. You can see on the weekly how we did accelerate. Last week we did 4.4 million. We're going, the swing point has 3.4 million it's going after. So that's 61. You can see last week we did 4.4 million. We've already done 3 million. It's Wednesday, so that's going to be, we get two more days. That means it's going to basically do the same as last week or bigger, and that's telling me that's going to bust this 61 and make a run up to this 79. So this is absolutely a personality stock, folks. And there's movement when it goes. There's no two ways about it. And so we'll see how it handles that higher price, because what you do have is that copper market wants higher price. This is a big move inside the copper market. And when copper starts moving, folks, okay, that can accelerate very quickly. In fact, let me do this quick. HG, I'm going to bring up I want the generic contract, because I want to bring this back further. Take this. Okay, so I'm putting this, oh, cool. They can see. Okay, so check this out. This is pretty cool. Now, it hasn't, let's see if this broken. It's really close. Yeah, it has. So when you take a look at this on a monthly, copper wants to make its run to 330. We broke that downtrend, and it's this month that we're breaking that downtrend in copper. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. Come back and visit us tomorrow morning, folks. Tommy kicks us off, 8:30. Great show.